And then look at the camera. Like that. Yeah, like James Bond on this thing. Let's talk about four books that every man should add to his library. All right, what's good, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. Happy New Year to everyone. I know it's been quite some time since I've dropped some content. I was planning to drop some videos over the Christmas holidays just because I had some downtime to myself, but I ended up catching COVID. So I was down sick over the Christmas holidays. I just kind of recovered within the last week and a half, 2 weeks. So I decided to get back to recording. So I wanted to drop some gems today. Hopefully you find these things encouraging and beneficial. But this video is going to be titled, Four Books Every Man Should Add to His Library. Is this thing on? Yeah, I think it's on. So the first book that I would highly recommend is a book titled The Circle Maker. It's written by Mark Batterson. I got this book as a gift from the college that I attended. On the day that I graduated, they gifted us all these books. So of course I thought it wasn't going to be very, very informative. This book changed my life forever. This book particularly talks about prayer and the importance of prayer and how you can pray for things and how to pray for things that you want to see manifest into your life. It talks about different experiences that the writer has had and how he's prayed things into his life. So for me, this book is important because it kind of started my interest into reading. I would highly recommend this book. I think it's just a good read, and this is what got me started. So this book will always be important to me. The next book, shout out to my homeboy J. Cole. Hopefully you're watching this. He told me about this book. One day it showed up at my house with no return label on it. So I don't know who sent it. Whoever sent it, thank you. But I read this book. It's about the law of attraction. It's about speaking positively, thinking positively, and how those things actually attract our experiences. This is a popular book. Most of you guys may have already read it or heard something about it. I'm just here nailing home the point. You definitely need to add the secret. The next book, The Alchemist. Shout out to my guy, Karsten Olsen. Karsten sent me this book back in like 2018. We just had started 40,000 Feet. I was pretty much on a journey trying to figure out what life meant to me and what did my career look like. All of us are on a journey, and some of us know where we're going and some of us have no clue where we're heading. But regardless, I think ultimately what gets us up in the morning is the idea that there is more work for us to be doing and more work to be done. And so the boy in this book eventually gets to the place that he thought was his treasure. And then realize that exactly where he was in the beginning was where he was supposed to be. He realized that his treasure was wherever he was. And so what he took back to this place was all of the lessons that he had learned. Out of all of these books, this is definitely my favorite book. All right, this is definitely my favorite book. Shout out to my former player, Seth. I gave Seth this book maybe a year ago. Just because I felt like it would be very beneficial to him. And to be honest, all of these books are a second buy for me. Usually what I do is I give them away. So I read them and then I usually try to give them away. I really bought these books again to do this video, if I'm being honest. One of my favorite quotes from this book is, on a man's journey, the universe is going to test every lesson that he's learned to make sure that he's mastered that lesson. Lastly, The Way of the Superior Man. If you're not a mature man, I don't know if I would recommend this one. If you're not ready to be, convicted and you're not ready to change your perspective on things and look inwardly, this might not be the best book for you. This book I actually got from Nipsey Hussle, not literally. Rest in peace, Nipsey. I'm a big fan of Nipsey. He has a list of books that he's recommended, you know, every man read. And this was one of those books. Typically, I take my time when I'm reading books. I don't try to zoom through them. But this book changed the way that I interacted with my world. And it says that basically, the way that you view your world is the way that you'll treat your woman. And so with that being said, it compares women to the world. And it also challenges us as men. this book is not for the weak. This book is not for a man who's underdeveloped and who does not understand himself and is not honest with himself. This book is for those who have decided who you want to be and you're headed in that direction and that you can handle, you know, sort of some tough love. This is a tough love book that I would definitely recommend mature men read. Once you finish a book, try to add another one to your collection. I'm not into the audiobooks. I like to read. Maybe that's old school and time consuming, but it's just something about the book, right, that I enjoy. So the book that I added to my collection was Message to the Black Man in America. Again, some would say this book is controversial because it's written by the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Regardless of my perspective, regardless on my, you know, religious beliefs and all those things, I feel like anything can teach us lessons. And so for me, I wanted to add this book just to get a different perspective, maybe different than I've had before. So I'm looking forward to peeling the pages back and continuing this book. It may take me a while to finish it because if you've ever read this book, it's quite a few pages, but the words are small, very small words. So I'm about 3 chapters in so far, really enjoying it. Again, I'm not saying that's one that you have to add to your library, but that's just what I'm currently reading. These are the 4, man. I definitely encourage you to add one of these 4 to your library, depending on where you are in life and depending on what your overall interests are. I appreciate you guys tuning in today. Hopefully you found something to be informative, enjoyable. I look forward to dropping more content this year. Glad to be back healthy. Again, I don't have a crazy direction that I'm trying to go with any of this. This is just a platform that I want to show more of my real, true self. So that's why I'm doing this. This is more of a outlet for me. All right. So I appreciate you guys tuning in. Definitely like, subscribe, and share this video. And look forward to continuing the journey with you guys. As always, keep it in the road. Yes, Sirski. Got me feeling so